Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. With the release of the 16-inch MacBook Pro 2021, the first PD3.1 charger has also been released. But the charging cable of the new MacBook Pro is USB-C to MagSafe 3. Maybe you've never seen any dual USB-C cable that supports PD3.1 and 240 watts. That's what we're gonna tear down today. Let's see what it looks like inside. This is a woven grain cable with two wide USB-C ports, and the protective sleeve can protect the junction and improve durability. The cable length is about 1 meter, the USB-C adopts full pin design. Use ChargerLab Power ZKM002C to test it. It's a passive data cable and only supports USB 2.0. But it also supports 50 volts, 5 amp, EPR. The chip supplier is Yihong Semiconductor. Connect it to Apple 140W charger and try to charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro 2021. We can see the power is only about 95 watts. That's because only the MagSafe 3 port supports 140W in new MacBook Pro. There are no devices that can support PD3.1 based on USB-C currently, so we can't actually test it, but it's theoretically possible. Next, let's cut it off. There is a layer of TPE under the woven mesh, and multiple wires are wrapped by shielding. Remove the TPE layer, we can see the shielding layer is also braided. There is another layer of aluminum foil shielding. Then we can finally see 7 different wires and a tensile wire inside. The red wire is the thickest and is used for charging. The yellow, green, blue, and white wires are covered with the insulating layer, and the other 3 are bare wires. Take a closer look at the red wire. There are some tensile fibers inside. The rest of wires are also mixed with tensile fibers. Here are 3 bare wires. Then let's take apart the USB-C connector. Use the Dremel to open it. The entire connector is reinforced by glue, and we can see the red PCB and solder joints. The e-marker chip and the solder joints of the positive and negative wires are on the back of the PCB. Clean up the glue. The e-marker chip comes from ConvenientPower. The red wire is the VBUS. Those colored wires are used to transmit signals and data. The other end adopts green PCB and reserved the pads of the e-marker chip. And we can see those colored wires and red VBUS wire on the back. Well, that's all for this 240W PD3.1 dual USB-C cable. It's very rare cable currently. The maximum current it supports is the same as the ordinary 100W cable, only 5A. But the supported voltage is greatly increased to 50 volts. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can click the corners to view relative teardown videos. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video.